What is the street parking vault? What started as the Monday retest workout turned into the weekly vault workout. The vault is a one workout a week for 25 weeks series with new workouts each year.
Now, the goal of the street parking vault is to help you guys build consistency by completing all 25 vault workouts within a 6-month period.
You can customize the movements in these workouts and choose any variation that fits your abilities.
Your scores and weights do not matter.
The goal is to maintain consistency from week to week.
Remember, you just can't
miss.
All right, you guys have made it. This is the last workout of the 2022 vault. Congratulations. Let's finish this off nice and strong. Today, we're tackling Ragnarok. I will be doing program B, which would be the barbell version. I have chosen 115, so a little bit more on the lower side of the extra challenge, which again, I'll be doing extra challenge with the 30 burpees. Jeb will be doing 30 burpees, which will be the extra challenge reps. He will be using the sandbag, and of course, choose the version that works best for you. Now, stick around until after the workout. I'll be giving my closeout tips. And make sure for the rest of the breakdown, you guys visit my.streetparking.com or you can visit the app.
All right, Miranda, let's get ready to Ragnarok.
We will Ragnarok you?
Yes. What is...
People have already turned it off. No one's watching now.
They're like,
forget this.
Wah, wah, wah. All right, so Ragnarok. What is Ragnarok, the full workout? Because it might be a little difficult to read on this one. What's the flow?
Oh, okay. I thought you were going to ask me to explain what Ragnarok is. And I was like, I thought that was your job here.
No, that's my job.
Okay.
That's my job.
So Ragnarok, the workout, is 5 rounds.
Yes.
Now, each round, you're going to start with, as you can see what they're doing, 20 lateral burpees over the sandbag or the barbell or your dumbbells, whatever you're using. After you finish 20 of those burpees, you're gonna do 2 rounds of 12 deadlifts, 9 hang power cleans, and 6 shoulder to overhead. So you can do push press, push jerk. You can do a strict press if you want to. I wouldn't recommend it. So it's 20, then 2 times 12, 9, 6, 12, 9, 6, then back to 20. All of that 5 times. You'll know you have done it correctly if you've done 100 burpees.
Ouch.
And a total of 10 rounds of the 12, 9, 6.
Wow, that is a lot of math.
So I did all the math for you guys there.
I appreciate all the math being done because I'm not necessarily the best at math while fitnessing.
Yeah, so it's not as confusing as it seems. With the sets and rounds, I know sometimes people get a little confused, but it's gonna be great. It's gonna be great. Now Julian's doing an extra challenge, so he's actually doing 30 burpees each time.
Yikes.
And he's using 115 today, and then Jeb's using the sandbag.
30 burpees, so he's adding an extra, 50 burpees on his situation?
Yes, that is good math. See, you got it.
I mean, 10 times 5. I got the 10 times tables down pat for sure. So before the workout, we asked them their strategies, and they're going to be breaking it up a little bit differently, the two of them. Once they get into the portion they're in now, Jeb's trying to hold on to it the whole way through. Julian's trying to take these breaks where he stops one rep before, picks it up again, goes into the next thing. What do you think you're going to do?
It depends on which version of the workout. I think that Jeb's strategy makes sense because he's using the sandbag.
Okay.
Or if you're using the dumbbells, I think it makes more sense because the dumbbells, you can't just drop it.
Yeah.
With the barbell, I like a good barbell drop.
I love a
good
barbell drop.
And I personally am good at taking short breaks when it's the barbell.
Yeah.
So if you know that you can do that, I'll tell you what, if you try to go unbroken, and especially if you try to do 2 rounds unbroken, like go straight from that last shoulder to overhead right into the deadlifts.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
That'll be great for your first round, maybe even your second.
But
and then you're gonna go to the burpees in your 3rd round and really regret it.
Yeah.
So be smart, keep the break short, but break where you need to for sure. And then just find a pace on the burpees.
Right on. Do you think you're going to do this workout with a barbell since you love a good barbell drop?
You know, it's been a long time since I've been able to like cycle a barbell and I'm feeling better. So yeah, I'll probably end up doing this with the barbell because it's just, this is a fun barbell workout if you've
100%,
got that.
100%, yeah. 100%. Almost always say I want to do the workout with a sandbag, but this is one I think I'm definitely going for the barbell for sure.
Yeah, I've seen a lot of people, I love a sandbag also. I've seen a lot of people who are getting like scraped up on their fingers and stuff from like movements like hang power cleans. So if you guys are going to go for the sandbag, it is a fun version, but maybe, you know, tape your hands beforehand because it's a lot of the hang power clean, I feel like, is what gets people that rotation.
100%. It always depends on like what your sandbag is, where you might get ripped up, but your thumbs are gonna pay in one way or another.
Yep. So they're on to round two. That first round took 3:30. Before we started, I told Julian that I thought he was gonna be under the goal time, which is 18 to 24 minutes.
Yeah.
Then I realized there were lateral burpees and that makes
little
a little
bit different, yeah, for sure.
So with that 3:30 pace, yeah, he's definitely going to be in the gold. I mean, they're right on track with each other. I'll be interested to see if Julian ever pulls away because Jeb is doing fewer burpees than him.
Oh, true.
Yes.
But Jeb's more of the, like, slow and steady guy.
Yeah, but Julian's the reverse peacocker. True. A lot of times he gets faster as he goes somehow.
We shall see how this all plays out.
That's right. So this is the last workout.
It's the last one. It's Ragnarok. This is the battle, the final battle that we've all been knowing was coming. You've heard us mention it here and there throughout this whole, I'll call it vault season.
So I feel like the final ones have been really gnarly every single time. 25 wasn't it? A 25-minute AMRAP.
It was
like devil press and air squats. That was 25, right?
It was something like I blacked out. I don't know. It was a
that
tough
was
workout.
One of them. That was one of them. And then they're meant to be long. They're meant to be really challenging. It's a lot of burpees.
It's going to be a lot of burpees because this one is literally the battle at the end of the world. That's going to be fought between the gods and the giants. We've talked about a couple of the prophecies going through when we hit the different workouts, but this is it. This is the final workout that you need to give your all to, and it's going to be a battle just like it says.
And honestly, it's a celebration. I did an Instagram post a while back about how fitness can be like how you approach workouts and how you are in the middle of the workout, how you talk to yourself and stuff can be a form of self-expression. If any of you guys have, this is your 25th, you have done all of the vault workouts, like this is a celebration for you too.
Yeah.
Like it's not the way that most people would choose to celebrate, but you guys should think about that as you're going. I mean, you'll have plenty of time.
It's a really tough victory lap.
Think about it. Think about how far you've come in the past 6 months. If you have been consistent and this is your final one, like, think about what this would have felt like maybe for you 6 months ago before you were so consistent. Or think about just all of that stuff, your attitude and how it's changed or how the movements feel easier for you or stuff that you've overcome in the past 6 months. I'm like preaching now. This is like a sermon at this point. But like I'm very an emotional person. People have probably figured that out about me.
I've noticed, yes.
So I reflect. It really is like a form of meditation. Maybe most people are like, how are you thinking about anything but not dying?
Well, everybody's different when it comes to a workout. So some people need to think about certain things to get them through. Other people are just completely zoned out, don't remember a workout at all. I hardly ever remember my workout after, like, what happened during.
For sure. When people are like, we did a workout like this 2 weeks ago, I'm like, I don't even know what we did yesterday. Julian almost lost count on that last, I think he did too few hang power cleans and realized it halfway up the first shoulder to overhead and went back.
Dang. It's okay.
So it's 12-9-6.
12-9-6. Gentle reminders.
So they're finishing up round two right at 7 minutes is where Julian's at.
Okay.
Math? Oh, he has another round of the...
Oh, awkward.
Of the two rounds.
Everything's fine. Let's distract. What is the shift version of this workout?
Oh, so we got a shift version. It's long. Okay. And sometimes the shifter's like, whoa, 18-minute AMRAP. Like,
doing?
This is a shift. I'll tell you this. If you're really fit, and because really fit people choose to do shifts sometimes, like Nelson.
Like me. I'm super really fit, and I do shift on the
I just want you to process this because you're in it for 18 minutes no matter what.
Yeah.
So if you're really fit, the reps are so that you're going to be able to keep moving because that's often how shift is designed.
Yeah.
You're going to end up doing a lot of work in 18 minutes. So it's 9 burpees, 12 deadlifts, 9 hang power cleans, 6 shoulder press.
Okay.
AMRAP, 18 minutes.
That's a lot.
It's very similar. Really, the only difference is that you're never doing 2 of those rounds back to back with the 12-9-6. And the burpee, you're only ever doing 9 at a time.
I like both of those things.
But it might mean that you actually end up doing
way more right?
If you're at a certain level of fitness.
It's funny, I find AMRAP so much more approachable, even though I might end up doing more, because I know when it ends, there's something that I can keep pushing. So mentally for me, AMRAP.
You know where the finish line is.
Yeah, I know what's up. I know I'm in this for 18 minutes. I know I can look up at the clock, and I know exactly how much time is left before I get to stop.
See, I tend to be the opposite. I like to just be like, you know what, this sucks, but if I just get these reps and rounds done with, I can stop. And you know, there's pros and cons of both, but it, always in an AMRAP, I'm the one that like looks up and I'm like, oh, cool, we're 90 seconds in, you know? And it's like, we have 16 and a half minutes left.
I purposely try not to look up. So I'm the person that if I'm doing something endurance related, I'm gonna put a shirt over the bike monitor or something like
yeah,
that.
I've
so
seen
I try
you do
to
that.
Block it out as much as possible.
You just hide from your problems?
Yes, but only in fitness. I mean, I'm totally completely mentally healthy.
Not based on the conversations we've had this week. That's a different,
truth.
That's a podcast episode,
truth.
Not,
that
not
is
for
the
Ragnarok.
Truth. Several times this week you've told me that I need to go to therapy, and that's okay.
No, I know you already go to therapy, just that you need to talk to your therapist about this one specific thing. Anyway, these guys are crushing it. They
yes.
don't look comfortable. It's nice and sunny here today. It's finally warm outside most of the time, sometimes here in the Pacific Northwest.
Oh, yeah.
And, you know,
it's a perfect day to do a workout in the shade with
summer
your shirt
grinding.
Off. Yes.
Summer grinding out here.
Tank tops are out.
Yep. Lots of sled work's been happening. Lots of sandbags and all that fun stuff. Hope you guys are having fun with that whole situation. And just throwing the Ragnarok in on top of it. Because it's a grind also.
Also definitely a grind. We're looking at, again, guys, the scores, your total time, if you're doing A, B, or C, and your goal is 18 to 24 minutes. So they are now 10 minutes in. They're about halfway through whatever that goal might be.
Julian just stopped during the burpees, which is not a good sign for everyone else.
That's a terrible sign.
Like, Julian stopped and was bent over during the burpees.
I'm sure he was just thinking about something, right?
Maybe
he's not totally
like he was just making sure his shoes were tied or something.
Yeah, there was probably a piece of dust on the ground he wanted to check out. Everything's fine. I'm not worried.
He got a haircut today just for this, so make sure you guys comment about his hair when he posts it. It's really important.
Very important part of this workout.
Okay.
Do you think Julian's approach of the breaking it up that one before is, you mentioned that it was good for like barbell, not necessarily dumbbell or sandbag.
It could be okay. So the 12-9-6, if you guys come from CrossFit, it's a workout called DT. It's one of their hero workouts. Mm-hmm. And it's just 5 rounds of 12-9-6.
It's actually one
and
of my favorite hero workouts.
Samesies.
Yeah,
I mean, it's just barbell cycling. It's fun.
Yeah, it's dope.
So if you recognize that, a lot of what people will do in that workout is they'll do exactly what Julian was saying. They'll go 11 deadlifts and then try to do the last deadlift and then the 9 and the 6 without dropping it.
Yeah.
That could also work well if it's starting to get grippy with the dumbbells. It's not going to get as grippy as if you were doing 5 rounds straight, like the original DT workout, because it's only ever 2 rounds at a time.
Mm-hmm.
So, you just have to decide like, okay, for you, for example, like if I were coaching you, Nicole,
this
workout, I know that you're comfortable with the weight.
Yeah.
The burpees are going to be what slows you down a little
treacherous.
Bit. So I would actually encourage you to try to go as unbroken as possible.
Yeah.
Because I know you need a little bit more time on the burpees.
Truth.
Julian obviously doesn't have a weakness between the two, so he's just trying to keep a steady pace throughout the workout. But if you're a fast burpeer, then maybe you want to break the weighted stuff a little bit more and try to keep that fast pace on the burpees. You got to know yourself. Fitness freedom, as Jeb's tank top. There's no one right approach to
it. Okay, I like that then. So if you're good, you're great at burpees, maybe break out the weighted. If you're not so great at burpees, go for it on the weighted and pace yourself through the burpees.
And either way, I would pace the last like 3 or 4 burpees, like stand all the way up, get a good breath and slow down your pace a little bit on the last few so that you can grab your sandbag or your dumbbells or your barbell right away.
Yeah.
Jeb lost count.
That's not good. That means you have to start at 1. Dang.
That was another Julian resting moment. I don't know if you guys caught that.
I think he was disguising it as a having a conversation with Jeb moment.
Right.
So this workout, guys, if you're anything like me, I highly recommend you have a whiteboard. You have something around, so anything around to count where you guys are at. Because at this point, I think I've heard two times people have said, oh no, I've lost count.
Oh no.
Which is dangerous in a workout
like
this.
Where you only have to keep track of one round at a time. That's right. And as soon as you finish your last shoulder to overhead each round, just mark it off the ticker or something like that.
Yeah.
Because sometimes oxygen...
Yeah, if you don't have enough oxygen.
It's not going to the brain enough to keep count.
I know my brain completely shuts off whenever I do any type of fitness. If I'm breaking a sweat, I've also broken my brain. That is just where I am in life, and there's no thinking until I'm finished. So make it as easy for yourself as possible.
So this is round 4 for Julian's burpees. I think Jeb is still on round 3 of his burpees. I think.
I mean, we've all lost count.
I feel like Jeb's been doing burpees for a really long time.
There's just a long way up, long way down.
Did I do 10 extra burpees? Like, the one or two, but sometimes I'm like, I might have been off by 10. I never am when I go watch the video, but it just feels that way sometimes.
That happened to Rachel the other day. She was so upset. It was, what was it? It was 100 of something. And at one point she's like, I am so tired. I have to be at this number. But it turns out she was like, 10 behind. Went back, watched the video, was so bummed out.
Oh yeah, I did see her post about that or a comment somewhere or something. Now let's talk about what happens after this week.
Let's.
Because it's like, oh, it's the final week. We have a lot of members who maybe joined partway through or this is their first year of the vault. Like, what happens after this week?
I mean, do it
we
again.
Have a bye week.
Yeah.
We have a bye week, as they say in professional football.
Yes,
as
that's
you know.
What they say. And then we do
and
it all again.
And usually that bye week is some disgusting, I can't remember what we have scheduled for that, but usually we choose like an old past vault workout.
Yeah, everyone thinks they have like a chill Monday.
I think last year was Banner's workout because he was new.
Not necessarily any more fun.
No, so we'll choose a past vault workout or something for next week, but then we start all over again. And the idea there is twofold. One, if you're into it, or maybe it depends on the workout, and you want to try to beat your old score, hopefully 6 months later, if you've been consistent, you haven't had injuries or had a baby or gotten super sick or something like that, you should be able to match or beat those scores and see how you've improved. I wouldn't necessarily recommend trying to do that every single week because that's mentally very stressful.
That's a lot.
But choose, here's how I would choose. Choose a couple of your favorites.
Yes.
And choose a couple that you hated so much and make yourself redo those exactly the way that you did them before and try to beat your score. But not all 25. For the rest of them, a couple things you can do is do a different version.
Yep.
If you did all of them shift the first time through, maybe choose a couple that you might feel comfortable doing program A with.
Yeah.
Even if you can't do 25 pounds and 40 pounds like lighter, it's totally fine. Or maybe you got a sandbag for summer grind and you want to try some of them with the sandbag. Whatever it might be, exercise your fitness freedom.
Heck yeah.
During the first few months, obviously, of the vault round 1, it was cold outside for most people, unless you're an Aussie.
I do love that part, the like switch of weather.
Yeah, so maybe you were doing a lot of them with like toe taps or the bike or something like that, and now you can actually go outside and run. That makes a big difference. I mean, I'm not looking forward to that part.
Yeah, and if you weren't a member this whole time and you want to start from the beginning or if you just forgot to log one.
So I have 4. I missed 4 when I had a baby.
Yes.
How many did you miss, Nicole?
What is 25 minus 4?
Nicole was a professional football player, okay?
I had football practice
during
a lot.
This whole time. So both Nicole and I will not be getting our badge.
Not until the second round.
I missed 4 somewhere right in the middle there. So if you missed some, if you came in late, you can still get the vault badge. You can still earn the ability to get the vault shirt.
Heck yeah.
But you got to finish the ones that you missed or forgot to log. There are many people who did them and they just forgot to log them. Julian's a great example of that.
Great example of forgetting to log.
Right.
100%.
Oh, he did a head shake. There was a head shake that time. Is this still round 4? We've been talking a lot.
We have been talking a lot. Oops. I did it again. Yeah, no, you can start over at the beginning. You can retry the ones you want to retry. You can, you know, do the ones you missed. It's fitness freedom all the way.
Uh-huh.
We're going to do it all again, so don't worry. You will have a chance. If you're listening right now and you're not even a member, you have a chance to still join and get the vault badge.
And you know what? A lot of people bought sleds and stuff like that, and there's some running in some of those early workouts before it starts getting cold again. Get out that pull sled, get out the push sled.
Do it.
One way that, you know, we've been talking about for Summer Grind that I like to do is if a workout has a 400 in it, for example, I'll do a 200-meter sled pull.
That's dope.
Or like a 100-meter sled push. The push is way worse for me.
I can't wait to hit the pull. That sled.
So, yeah, play around with it. Use your fitness freedom. Look at your notes from last time if you wrote some notes about like where you fell apart or I should have gone lighter or I could have gone heavier and give yourself an opportunity to do that stuff.
Yeah, it'll be awesome. And then, you know, after the bye week, we're going to start back over with the first vault, which was Emir. Remember Emir? Emerged from the Gnunga Gap.
I do remember our
Gnunga
discussion about it.
Yes. So take a bye week and then we'll see you in the Gnunga Gap right after that bye week is over. It's going to be awesome. We get to start all over again. You get to work your way up through the vault ending at Ragnarok.
I think this is still round four. So that goal time of 18 to 24 minutes. I mean, you guys, you know what?
Nailed it.
Just finish it. I'm going to give you permission this time to just, as long as you're moving safely, if you get two rounds in and you're like, there's no way, this is going to take me 30 minutes, take 30 minutes.
Yeah.
Go for it this time.
Battle it out.
I don't often give that advice.
Yeah, yeah.
I say make a change. Only make a change if you're not moving safely. Like, this is just way too heavy for me and I'm like doing singles.
Yeah.
But if it's just hard.
Yeah.
It's the last vault workout. You've been working for 6 months. Just let it be hard.
It's a battle.
Yes.
Just let it be hard.
Just let it be hard. Sometimes that's okay. It's
sometimes.
If you're going over the goal time every day, then you're missing the point.
Yeah.
But this is one of those opportunities where it's like, no, it's the vault. It's the final one.
It's
I just want to do it.
The battle
and
at
not
the end of
the lower
world.
The burpees or not. Yeah, go for it.
There's no time cap on a battle.
There should be.
Did he finish?
Nope.
Oh.
Nope.
Awkward. Awkward. Just thinking about
Hope he ate breakfast today.
He did a little late, though.
Yeah,
he might be feeling some of that breakfast.
You know what? He hasn't had any of my homemade cold brew today.
Maybe he needs a sip to get through it. A little extra fuel. Just bring him. Hey, would you like some coffee?
You know, our boys did wake us up super early today, though. Like 5 a.m. early.
Ooh, bummer.
Yeah. And that's the beauty of street parking, because a lot of times, you know, when you watch people do exercise on the internet, they weren't woken up at 5 a.m. by their children that day. They were in a hotel with people and massage therapists and, you know, STEM machines.
Ooh, massage therapists and STEM machines. That
Not
sounds
us.
Nice.
Not us here at street parking. We're too badass for that.
Is that what we are?
I think.
Cool, I'll take it. Badass.
Yeah, I think it's pretty badass.
I'm badass.
I don't have a... Julian didn't have an entourage of people in the warm-up area.
No.
You know.
Oh, yeah. They're in the thick of it for sure.
Oh, yeah. We're at 21 minutes in. I do think Julian will still finish under 24, so good news. Julian
100%.
Made the time goal.
That's always dangerous when that doesn't happen.
If he does, I told him to use 135.
You sure did. And he said, you can't pressure me into that. Not for this one. But to be fair, you forgot that it was lateral.
I did.
Right. So that makes sense.
I thought
if
it was
regular
burpees, which he's fast at both, but the jump over just, it's a whole different.
Yeah.
It just slows you down. Jeb just walked off for water. I don't know what is happening here, you guys, but obviously... they understood the assignment.
Yes. 100% understood.
Oh, he's done.
Yeah, Jeb.
He was a round ahead.
Yeah, Jeb.
I thought he was a round behind, but he's a round ahead. Good job, Jeb.
That's what's up. Yeah, Jeb. What was your time? Jeb, what was your time?
He can't hear you at all. The ears are gone. He's old also.
That's true.
I would like to, you know, give a little shout out for this year's vault. Other than the repeat workouts, which we had a few, were all brought to you by Coach Jeb and Coach Alex.
Brought to you
programming
by...
Programming extraordinaires. All 25, other than the repeats, were brought to you by Jeb and Alex. If you would like to think back to the Wolf Complex workout, that was specifically brought to you by Jeb.
100%. That one got a lot of heat on the interwebs.
It was great.
A lot of quote-unquote love was shown for that workout.
You know, it's 2022. Everybody loves a good conspiracy theory, and everyone loves to be angry at someone on the internet. So we'll give you guys opportunities to do that whenever possible.
There you go. Hashtag blame Jeb.
All right. Yep. Here he's going to finish up here. Last round of the 12.96. Just under that goal time.
Just under.
Just sneaking in.
Sneaking, sliding right into the goal time right here.
My favorite is that because Julian will not be happy with the fact that he was so close to the goal time, he will be repeating this workout.
Probably, right? Probably going to make
probably,
probably
going to
go with Salvi.
Before 6 months, he'll probably do it in a few days from now.
He probably will, I feel. I think you might be right on that.
With Salvi and Kaylee.
Yep.
It's always that group,
the
you know.
The three of them go at
full
it like
full blackout
crazy.
Group.
Oh, he's eyeing the clock. He's eyeing that clock.
Oh, man. He is not. There he was goes. Not. Oh, man. 10 seconds.
1, 2.
Don't forget to run to the finish line.
There it is. 23:56 with 4 seconds to spare.
Nice.
Right in the time that he was aiming for. Not necessarily the side of the time he was aiming for, but he did it.
Great.
That was awesome.
Great.
That was perfect.
All right.
So are we going to be getting tips from
I think we
Jeb
should.
Or Julian?
I think we should get some tips, maybe a few tips from both of them.
Yeah, maybe we start with Jeb.
Okay.
Because he's had a moment. Let's see what Jeb has to say about this workout.
All right. So while Julian's recovering here, give you some tips. You really gotta ask yourself, do I want this to be a burpee workout or more of like a DT, more of like a weighted workout with your barbell or your dumbbells? Sandbag version, for me, doing the 30 burpees, it really came down to the burpees. Doing the sandbag movements was actually kind of a welcome break from the burpees, and I was able to kind of recover slightly from one section of the workout to help me go into the next section, if that makes sense. So I would say, you know, if you look at the times, there was a fight for us to get into the goal range. So only go extra challenge if you really think that you can get into that goal range, because you're going from 100 burpees to 150 burpees in this workout, which is a big jump. So just be mindful of that. And really the goal is the goal. It's to stay within 18 to 24 minutes. I will let Julian talk to you about the how to select your weight and that kind of thing.
All right, so you got to keep in mind the burpees will make or break on this workout. You have to, especially the first round, the opening round, slow it down, like purposefully pause after every 10 reps. Some of you guys might even benefit a lot from pausing every 5, because if you go too hard, you spike your heart rate, and then it takes longer and longer for you to pick up that barbell. The barbell, choose a weight that you know you can pick it up easily, knock out 5+ deadlift reps, break when you only have a couple left or 1 left, transition smoothly to the last deadlift into the hang power clean. What was working for me is getting over the halfway mark, so dumping after 7 or 8 reps, and then pick up, finish it, and go right into the shoulder to overhead. Those are appropriate breaks, especially in the first 3 rounds, because it'll help you find a pace. Because again, round 3, 4, 5 is where it really just eats you up. So I know my first round was so much faster than my closer rounds, and I made that mistake by starting a little bit too fast. So again, the burpees, slow it down on purpose so you get your heart rate down a little bit going into the barbell cycling, especially if that's a weakness of yours. So be smart about how you approach that. If after the first round, the barbell cycling takes you more than 3 minutes, you might have gone a little bit too heavy, tone it back a little bit. Don't be afraid to make an adjustment, it's okay. Remember, we're always gonna revisit these workouts, so. But that's it, goal time is very appropriate. I did the extra challenge, and I was barely able to sneak under the back end of it. So I felt good about that, honestly. Make sure you eat a really good meal beforehand, because this is starting getting chills towards the end and it's actually really hot. So I know what that means. Congratulations on finishing the last workout of the 2022 vault. We'll see you guys soon.
Welcome to week 25 of the 2022 vault. You've made it. This is it. This is going to close out the series. And for that, we've saved the best for last. In this workout, we are tackling Ragnarok. Ragnarok is 20 lateral burpee over barbell into two rounds of 12 deadlift, 9 hang power clean, 6 shoulder to overhead. You will repeat that 5 total rounds. Your score for this workout will be your total time, and a good goal to shoot for is to try to finish somewhere in between 18 to 24 minutes. All right, here are my tips for this workout. Now remember, just so we understand the flow of this workout, each round you will complete the 20 burpees over your object, and then you'll do 2 rounds of the 12-9-6. That is 1 round. So yes, just to do the math, which I usually don't like to because it starts to freak people out, it will be a total of 100 burpees over the course of the 5 rounds, followed by 10 total rounds of the 12-9-6 complex. So let's dive into how we're gonna approach this so that way we end up finishing this workout and not be so crushed, but although I cannot promise that you won't feel crushed after this. When doing the burpees, remember it's all about pacing yourself and finding a smooth, comfortable flow for that going into the complex. For the complex, when you do your deadlifts, I would say break couple reps before you go right into the hang power clean, because it's a smooth transition going from there into the next movement and then going right into the shoulder to overhead. So try your best to knock out the hang power cleans and the shoulder to overhead in one set. Once you break that, that's your recovery window before you start your deadlifts, and you keep repeating that cycle over the course of the 5 rounds. To view detailed demos of the movements in today's workout, as well as any of the customizations, make sure you guys visit my.streetparking.com. Welcome to week 25 of the 2022 vault. Congratulations, you've made it all the way here. This is the last workout, and we've saved the best for last. This week, we are tackling Ragnarok. The shift workout is 18-minute AMRAP of 9 burpee, followed by 12 dumbbell deadlift, 9 dumbbell hang power clean, 6 dumbbell shoulder press. Your score for this workout will be your total rounds and reps, and a good goal to shoot for is somewhere in between 6 to 9 rounds. All right, here are my tips for this version. When it comes to the burpees, make sure you guys find a comfortable pace that works for you. That's busy work going into the complex, which is gonna be the make or break. The 12 deadlifts, knock out a big set, but I won't suggest going and broken there. So that way you have an actual break that you look forward to. So that way you can recover a little bit, give your grip a little bit of a chance to recover before you pick up, transition smoothly into the hang power clean and into the presses. That's where I'll suggest that you hold on to those dumbbells. Then after that, break, recover a little bit before you pick up going into your next round. Keep that flow going, and I guarantee you this will be a little bit more manageable. Have fun and finish off the vault nice and strong. To view detailed demos of the movements in today's workout, as well as any of the customizations, make sure you guys visit my.streetparking.com.